Hi, my name's Hugh Edwards, Stations Director at HS2, and I'm thrilled to bring you the latest update on the delivery of HS2, Britain's new high-speed railway. HS2 lays the foundations for a 21st and 22nd century railway network, providing more tracks, more trains, more seats, more connections, and faster journeys to improve performance and reliability across the wider railway network. The HS2 scheme will transform the way we move between our major cities, with zero carbon journeys between Birmingham and London, and services then continuing onwards to Manchester, the Northwest, and Scotland on the existing railway network. HS2 is at peak construction right now, employing over 31,000 people day in and day out, bringing together the best of British design and British engineering. In our last update, we looked at progress made across 2023, and that momentum has continued right into 2024, with many major construction milestones already achieved and many more to come. Below ground, we've seen three of our giant tunnel boring machines complete their tunnelling drives in the first quarter of 2024. In January, we celebrated tunnel boring machine Lydia's breakthrough into the Old Oak Common station box, signifying the completion of the Atlas Road logistics tunnel, which is a key part of our plans to enable the future construction of tunnels that will carry high-speed trains into Euston. This was followed up by the completion of tunnelling for the route's longest tunnel, with tunnel boring machines Florence and Cecilia finishing their epic 10-mile journeys under the Chiltern Hills and breaking through at the northern portal in Buckinghamshire in spectacular style. And while Lydia, Florence and Cecilia have completed their drives and are already in the process of being carefully dismantled, we've ramped up tunnelling activities in London and in the West Midlands with the launch of a further three tunnel boring machines. TBM's Emily and Anne started their drives some 25 metres below ground in West London, digging the new HS2 tunnels under the capital for the first time. And in the West Midlands, TBM Elizabeth has also been launched, joining her sister machine Mary Ann in digging the 3.5-mile Bromford Tunnel, which will surface near our Washworth Heath depot complex. This tunnel will take our trains in and out of central Birmingham. Over half of the 56 miles of bored rail tunnels on HS2 have now been completed. Above ground this year, we've seen many more of HS2's major bridges and viaducts take shape, with a range of innovative and world-class engineering techniques being used along the line of routes to push these structures, slide them, cast them on site, or lift them into place with some of the biggest cranes available in Europe. When HS2 is operational, our trains will travel on dedicated, resilient and reliable tracks, below ground in tunnels and cuttings, and above ground across a network of embankments, bridges and viaducts at speeds of up to 225 miles an hour, helping almost halve the journey time between Britain's two largest cities. For our future passengers, stations at Birmingham, Curzon Street, Interchange and Old Oak Common in Euston will be vibrant and accessible transport hubs, putting hundreds of destinations within easy reach. On the ground today, our priority is to deliver modern, eco-friendly stations, maintaining the fantastic momentum we built up to ensure initial high-speed services between Old Oak Common and Birmingham Curzon are operational by the early 2030s. Today, I'm at Old Oak Common, which is set to be the best connected and largest new railway station ever built in Britain. With its modern design, Old Oak Common offers seamless travel, making journeys in and out and around central London's transport system quick, easy, convenient and efficient. From Old Oak Common, London's West End will be just 10 minutes away on the newly opened state-of-the-art Elizabeth Line, with Liverpool Street Station just 20 minutes away and in the other direction, Heathrow Airport just 10 minutes away on the Heathrow Express. And beyond London, Old Oak Common will serve as a gateway to Wales and the South West through Great Western mainline services. This once industrial area of West London is being transformed into a thriving, super-connected neighbourhood and an exciting development that will build a legacy for the local community to be enjoyed for generations to come. Brand new Interchange Station in Solihull is set to revolutionise public transport in the West Midlands area and beyond. With seamless connections between HS2's Interchange Station, the NEC, Birmingham International Station and Birmingham Airport, local roads and the UK motorway network, this station is primed to become the ultimate hub for commuters and leisure travellers alike. Just like Old Oak Common Station, Interchange Station will be the top 1% of eco-friendly buildings in Britain, making it a global trailblazer in sustainable design and leading the charge towards a greener future. Years of meticulous planning and preparation has been taking place on this site, from removing existing infrastructure, such as these bridges over the M42, to remodeling local roads and utility networks, creating space for construction of the station to begin next year. In the heart of Birmingham, construction's underway on the landmark Curzon Street station, heralding a new era of rail travel in the West Midlands. This station, inspired by Victorian railway architecture and engineering, embodies our commitment to blending tradition with innovation. The station will deliver excellent connectivity into the east side and Digbeth areas of Birmingham, and is already enabling wider regeneration in the area. There will be seamless connections to the local transport network, including buses and the West Midlands Metro, with a tram line running alongside and under the station, as we work closely with the West Midlands Combined Authority, including transport for the West Midlands. With our construction partners, we've developed a detailed programme, and work has begun on the station foundations, which will continue through the remainder of this year. Investment in our railways means two things: better journeys and economic growth. Firms from every nation and region of Britain are already helping to build HS2 today, with over 3,000 businesses having already won contracts. The delivery of HS2 is opening up multi-billion pound development projects in areas surrounding our new stations in both London and the West Midlands. The investment HS2 has attracted to the West Midlands is projected to add an additional £10 billion to the local economy over the next 10 years, creating 41,000 additional homes and 30,000 new jobs. Regeneration in West London, meanwhile, at Old Oak Common, is set to provide 25,000 new homes and 60,000 jobs. As the catalyst for urban regeneration, improved local transport connections, increased housing provision, and of course, new jobs, HS2 benefits local people, local businesses, and the wider economy. Thank you for joining us on this journey, and stay tuned for more updates as we continue to deliver HS2. If you like what you've seen, click comment, like, subscribe.